Oh, fuck. Fuck. Oh, Jesus Christ. If you hadn't come along.
You want to come with me? I'm gathering any supplies I can find at the water sports rental kiosk. Maybe you'll find something that'll come in handy.
There's a table inside you can use to repair your weapons.
Look, take whatever you want. I have to get some rest. I'll rest up and then head out to meet my wife. I would have died out there without you.
Improving.
Oh my God.
Where are you?
Oh!
More. Damage.
Thank you.
Mayday. This is Oceanic Flight 1012. All engines are out. Repeat, all engines are out. Ground control, do you read? We're making an emergency landing north of the city in the jungle. To all stations, I repeat.
Take a look.
Flight 1012. All engines are out. Repeat, all engines are out. Ground control.
Nice job, mates. We're safe now, thanks to you. But we won't make it long without food. If help don't come soon, we're gonna have to head to town. Meantime, maybe you could see if anybody needs help. We're safe here for now, but there's still a lot to do. A lot of people here need help. Go talk to them and see what you can do.
Dominic, this piece of shit antenna's too weak to reach past the island. We need a signal amplifier to cut through the static. I worked on an antenna at the lighthouse nearby. I'm sure they got an amplifier there. We wouldn't last a minute against those things, but you, think you can get it for us?
Absolutely.
All right, excellent. You bring it back as soon as you can.
It's almost useless now. Please,
hey.
My husband, he's bleeding. Can you help us?
Name's Roger, brothers. And this is my wife, Jess. We were driving like a bat out of hell when I saw that broke down car. Part of me said, forget about it. But I couldn't do that and live with myself. So we stopped to see if we could help. The driver must have been in shock or something because he threw himself at us like a crazy guy. I had to kill him. But this was self-defense. I was protecting myself. You gotta believe me. But you know what? He took a bite out of me, man. Shit. I think I got whatever he had. Rabies. I don't know. Fuck. Who the hell knows? But can you get Jess out of here? If I start to lose it, I don't want to bloody hurt her.
Yes.
Hey, man. Thanks. Should take her to the lighthouse. My brother James should be there. He'll take her in.
Stronger.
I think we got a live one. Hey, up here.
Hello. It's nice to see someone who isn't dead.
There are people living in the lighthouse? Thank you. Can you check on my husband?
Can't be.
I can't believe you're alive. When we left Cinemoyen. You better go see the James.
I'm sure I'll be surprised as hell to see you still alive and kicking.
Follow me, I'll take you to James.
I'm sure he'll be glad to see you still alive. James will probably want to talk to you first. He's in the back there. You should go talk to him. James is at the top of the lighthouse. Go see him.
Talk to James first. He's the one in charge.
Holy shit, you're alive?
I'm James. You don't know me, but I sure remember you. Me and Cinemoy had a slight difference of opinion. He wanted to stay put and wait for help. I wanted to get the hell out of there. So I got the hell out. Now, we're working on setting up the lighthouse to signal for assistance. We sure could use your help.
All right.
Now, if you want to get off this island with the rest of us, go talk to my people. See what you can do to help, okay?
I'm approaching the location where I'm to meet my informant. I must say, everything seems oddly quiet and deserted in here. I'm a little concerned that my informant has been exposed. I hope he's all right. The door appears to be ajar. Mr. Anomo? Hello? Anyone here? There's blood everywhere. I don't see a body, though. Mr. Anomo?
What the hell?
Jesus Christ! Oh, my God! Oh, my God.
whoever that was. I think I just killed her. Bashed her head in with a fucking lamp. She was out of her mind. She tried to bite me, for Christ's sake. She must have been 70 years old.
Let's open this up.
Someone else is back there. I gotta
get through.
I gotta get out of here.
Hell? We followed James to this lighthouse so we could send out an SOS signal using the lamp. But there's something wrong with the power. Marcus went to check the two transformers powering the lighthouse, but he's been gone for hours. Someone needs to see what's happened to him and try to get the power back on. Those things can't do to you what they can do to us. Maybe you can help us.
I'll do my best.
All right. Good. The transformers are in the northern part of the Gold Bungalow area. If you can get the power back on, I'll let you into the storage shed. I'm Darvin, by the way.
Did you see the plane that went down?
I send you to hell!
Yeah. Name's Marcus. I was fixing this piece of shit when these things came out of nowhere. See if you can get that other transformer back online while I finish fixing this one. Go!
This weapon is coming apart! Damage.
All right, everything works. Go tell Darwin the good news. I'll stay here just in case the fuses blow when you start pulling power for the lighthouse. This is for you. Thanks for the help. The world's gone fucking mad!
Just hope the bloody fuses don't blow.
Huh.
Where the hell did I put that?
Can you come closer?
Okay. If Marcus said it's gonna work, let's give it a shot and turn it on. I just hope it doesn't bring down the electrical grid. Looks like it worked. Come on, I'll open the storage shed for you.
Maybe there's something useful.
I desperately need food. I ate everything in the minibar and I'm starving here.
Come over here. I've got a job for you.
Nice. Maybe we can finally get this fucker to work. Thanks.
Look, are you hearing me?
This baby needs some new spark plugs or she ain't going nowhere. Shame, though. It's a hell of a car. A battalion of those freaks wouldn't slow this baby down. So, if you can find me a few necessary parts from any nearby wrecked cars, and we get this ride rolling, I'll let you take her out anytime you want. Deal?
Yes.
Excellent. You locate those parts, you know where to find me. Whoa, great job. Nice. Now just give me a sec, and I'll get this bitch running.
Feel like I'm back in fucking Iraq. These bodies are starting to rot. You smell that? We need to burn them before they start attracting more of these walking dead motherfuckers. Do me a favor. See if you can't get some gas from that station nearby.
I'll do my best.
Okay, good. See if you can find a car. That way you can move more gas.
Thank you.
Hey, you! Go over to the door! Give me a sec to open it. Come on, quick!
Can't hurt to look.
What, you want gas? Sorry, the pumps ain't working. Power's out and the generator's in the warehouse next door. Unfortunately, the front entrance is blocked. Yeah, maybe there's another way in. See, try the roof. That might work. Head out the back so they don't see you. And take some canisters with. Yo, once you get in, turn on the power and refuel those canisters. Now that we're here, we're not moving anywhere. It's too friggin' dangerous out there.
ever.
Hurry it up. These fuckers are...
Hey, thank you. This should do it. By the way, I'm Mike. I got the bodies piled up outside. Guess we better do this.
Like a dream. This ride is yours whenever you need it.
Done without you, mate. You got a moment to talk? I got the radio going, but I'm not hearing anything. Either this guy is farther away than I thought, or the monsoon's messing with the transmission. This may take a while, but don't worry. I have something for you to do in the meantime. We're running very low on food and water. Think you can find some?
Absolutely.
Okay then, don't bother with the hotel. With the power out, it's way too dangerous in there. Check the bars by the swimming pools. Bring everything you can find, anything at all, okay? In the meantime, I'll keep trying to reach this guy.